Myself PV Ekhande, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we'll see regarding the solving problems related to the planes when the coordinate systems are given. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the problems of projections of planes when the coordinate systems for the plane are given. Now let us consider the point coordinates are given. Here the example is in which we have to find out the inclination of triangular plane PQR with the vertical plane VP, that is a vertical plane, and for this the coordinates of the points which are given are P, Q and R. Now P, for that three figures are given in the bracket, and these three figures are indicating the position of points in the front view and top view on the coordinate systems, that is X and Y. In this 30 figure indicates the distance in X direction for point P, and in Y direction the first point is a 50 mm distance and the second point is 110 distance. Means at 30 mm on X axis, first point is to be completed at 50 mm distance, which will give us the position of point in the top view, and the second point, which is to be located at 110, that is 110 mm, that will give us position of point in the front view, that is a PF. Like that the other points can be located. Now we'll see how to complete the problem when these three coordinates are known to us. Here we have to draw X and Y line, X and Y coordinate. On that we'll be marking the distance. Now here the first point which is given is a point P which we are going to locate on X axis first. Now here on X axis we'll locate the point at distance equal to 30 mm, and with respect to that then we'll complete the position of the point with the 50 and 110 mm distance. Now first point we'll complete on this line which is at 30 mm distance, and the distance given for first point is 50 mm on Y axis. So we'll locate the point at 50 mm distance, which will be the first point, and second point is at 110 mm distance. So this point is at 110 mm. So we'll have the position of first point PH at this location, and that point is to be called as PH because the point is in the top view. Similarly, we'll have the location of second point, that is PF, on the 30 mm distance on X axis, and the point is to be called as PF because that is a point in the front view. Now the second point, which is Q point, for that the distance on X axis is 50 mm and the other two distances are given on Y axis, that is 20 and 140. So first we'll locate the point at 50 mm distance on X axis. So this 50 mm distance, on this line will get the position of the points in the front view and top view. Now here the distance on Y axis, that is 20 and 140. So 20 will be the first point and second point is 140 mm distance. So this is 140. Now we'll have the location of these two points by drawing the line parallel from these positions to the axis line, X axis line, and the points are to be called as Q with suffix H for the top view point, and for the front view point it is to be called as QF. So these are the two points for this cube. Now the third point, third corner, that is R, which is at distance equal to 90, 70 and 100, that is 100 millimeter. So on x axis, first we'll have the location of that point at 90 millimeter. We'll draw the line parallel to y axis from this 90 millimeter distance point. Now on this 90 millimeter distance line, we have to locate the points at 70 and 100 millimeter. So first we'll have the location of this at 70 millimeter distance, and the other point will be at 100 millimeter distance. With this, we'll complete the line in the parallel condition to x axis to obtain the position of RF and RH. So this point is RF and this point is RH. Now once we'll complete the three points, the next step is to connect these three corners and complete the triangle in the front view and top view. We have to connect these three points to obtain the triangle in the top view, and similarly in the top view, in the front view, we'll have the line connecting these three corners to obtain the position of plane PQR in the front view and top view. Now this is regarding completion of front view and top view when the coordinate systems are given. Now the next step is to obtain the inclination or angle of plane with vertical plane. Now first we'll complete the reference line in between these two at certain distance, so that that will become XY line or FH line. So that is a reference line FH, or we can call that as a XY, because F indicates frontal plane, the frontal area is on the top side, and in the bottom side it is the HRP, that is the horizontal reference plane area. We want the angle with vertical plane, so we should obtain the HV of the plane on this side, so that the reference line which is to be completed over here will be a F1 line, and with respect to that, whatever the angle for the HV is obtained, that gives us the angle of the plane with vertical plane or frontal reference plane. And for obtaining the HV, the first step is to draw the line parallel in the adjacent view, so that we'll get the true length of that line in the adjacent front view. So we'll draw the line parallel from this P point, which will have the intersection at this location. So this point will indicate as a MH. Now we have to project this MH point in the front view, so that the true length of that line will be obtained. So this point is MF point. Now when we'll connect this PF to MF, that gives us true length of the line PM, and when we'll complete the line perpendicular to this true length line, that gives us the point view of this point, and ultimately we'll obtain the edge view on this side. So this is the projector drawn from that, and we'll complete the line perpendicular to this, that gives us the edge view. Now this reference plane which we are completing over here, that is a F1 plane, and on this side the edge view will be obtained, which will have the angle opposite to this F, means opposite to vertical plane. So that is nothing but the angle made by the plane with vertical plane. So first point we can locate by marking the distance from this side. Now this distance is 30 millimeter over here, or we can have the distance in the compass which can be transferred on this side. So this is a point which is completed on the auxiliary view, which is called as a P1 point. Similarly, we have to project the point from this RF and QF. RF and QF. From this we will have the completion of projectors, and on these projectors we will have the marking of the points R1 and Q1 by transferring the distance from this reference plane. So the distance for this R, which we can take in the compass, or we can mark the distance 10 millimeter over here on the projector of this. So that gives us the position of R point. So that R point is to be denoted as R1 over here. Similarly, we have to locate Q1 point over here by marking the distance of this Q. So taking the distance in compass or marking the distance from this side, it gives us the location of that point. And when we will have the connection of these two points and extending that one, it should get the location somewhere here, which will be the distance from this reference line. So instead of considering the distance first, we will have the extension, and later on we will have the cross checking of the point whether that distance is obtained at same point, same distance or not. Suppose this is a Q1 point which we have obtained over here at 61 millimeter distance. So this is the edge view which is obtained over here, and the edge view makes an angle with vertical plane over here. So this angle we can measure at the location R, or we can have the extension of this over here, and you can measure the angle over here. So when we measure the angle at this location, the angle obtained is 50 degrees. So this 50 degrees is the angle of the plane with vertical plane, plane PQR with vertical plane. So we have to write the answer as a angle of plane PQR is 50 degrees with vertical. Got the idea cleared regarding obtaining the angle, where the angle is to be considered when the angle of the plane is with vertical plane, whether it is on front view side or top view side. Correct, you have to obtain that on the front view side. For this, the reference taken is from Dabade ML book. Thank you.